What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim, and oh snap, it's gonna be an awesome freaking day. But first, if you guys enjoy what you're about to see, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter. Link is down there in the description. So, guys, take a look at the sword that is on my left side. Freaking hell, it is like the size of me. So what are we checking out today, guys? Well, this sword and five others just like it. So the mod we're looking at today, guys, is known as Soul Reaver, and it's actually by the same mod author that has done this mod right here. Pretty interesting. This mod author has put out quite a few mods, and I've done showcases on them in the past. So what does this add exactly? Well, it adds a new sword to the game, but there are six variants in total. You have the Soul Reaver, the Reaver of Frost, Reaver of Flame, Darkness, Ruin, and Legend. Very, very cool names for these swords. Here's all the other work that this mod author has done. I've done quite a few of those on showcases, and there's still more to come. But let's check this out together. So, these are the swords. They are crazy looking. I don't even know what the hell these things would come from, but let's go ahead and drop this one and see what it looks like on the ground. So let's see, let's go ahead and do my handy dandy little cheat spell, and we'll go toggle collision so we can get a better look at this sword up close. But I mean, just look at the textures, dude, they look so damn cool. I mean, there's just something about this sword that screams kind of cartoony, but also if you get too close to me, I will literally kill you. It's just, I don't know, it's something about the colors, and it's like everything about it. I don't know, it just looks super cool. One of the cooler looking blades, but let's go ahead and check out its counterparts, because the cool part is every blade has its own color and its own enchantment. So right here, Soul Reaver of Ruin, we've got 62 points of stamina damage, target takes 37 points of shock damage and half as much magicka damage. This one, victim does not treat an attack with this weapon as assault, which is kind of interesting. Target is paralyzed for 3 seconds and it absorbs 22 points of health. Plus, these swords are quite valuable and they're not too expensive to make. Then we got the Soul Reaver of Frost. Target takes 18 points of frost damage to health and stamina. Soul Reaver of Flame burns the target for 25 points, targets on fire, then take extra damage, and finally, the Soul Reaver of Darkness does 50 points of magicka damage, chance to paralyze the target for 5 seconds. So let's go ahead and take a look at each of these together. It's gonna be floating because I'm floating, but that just makes it all the better. So as you can see, you can kind of see the enchantment that's chilling on this one, and it's kind of creepy, I gotta say. It looks so nice though. The textures on the swords just look so cool. Then we got the Soul Reaver of Flame, which I gotta say, this one's probably my favorite. I love the skull with the horns right there, it just looks so freaking cool. And I don't know, it's just, there's something about the textures, it's not super, like, uber realistic looking, but it screams fantasy, you know? Like, it looks like something that would be out of Diablo 3 or something like that. Something a little bit more fantasy rather than Skyrim being kind of more realistic fantasy, you know? Just kind of cool, I don't know, it's just something about it. And then we got the Soul Reaver of Frost, which this one's beautiful too, but it looks quite a lot like this one right here. This one's kind of a more turquoise. This one's more, well, actually, I don't even know. They look fairly similar. This one's a little bit darker blue, and this one's much brighter blue, much more overwhelming, but it is a sword of frost, so it kind of has to be, you know? Just beautiful. I love the freaking textures. They look so cool. And then, let's see, we got the Soul Reaver of Legend, and this one, I don't know, it's just something about the yellows and the blacks and then the grays just mixes so well. And in fact, there's a little bit of green in there too. Oh, but can you see the red pulsating on the sword? That looks so cool. Oh, that just looks so damn awesome. And then, last but not least, we've got the Soul Reaver of, what was it? Soul Reaver of Ruin? And I like this one too. I gotta say, this one and the Soul Reaver of Flame, definitely my two favorites, with this one not far behind. But damn, dude, they just look so freaking cool. I also love how they're all floating. It kind of looks really cool. But the textures, I just love them so much, dude. I could say that a million times more in this video, but it's definitely a mod to check out. If you're more of a fan of, like, the super uber fantasy swords or something that would, like, be a little bit out of the ordinary for Skyrim, this mod is for you. Plus, they got decent stats, guys. They've definitely got some decent stats. These have been tempered, though, so take that with a grain of salt. Let's see, there should be one more. There it is. So, as you can see, me go ahead and mute my computer there. Sorry about that. As you can see, the stats, we got 45 damage on this one, which is just the regular one. And then this one, we got 56 damage. This one, we got 56 damage. This one, we got 56 damage. This one, we've got 67. And this one, we've got 56. So overall, on average, they do 56 damage. But the cool part is the ones that do 56 damage have extra perks to them. So it might freeze them. It might set them on fire. It might take magicka and health from them, you know? So definitely one of the cooler mods, guys, especially one of the more fantasy-esque sword mods. And I think if you're really into that kind of stuff, this mod is for you. So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's little mod showcase, and if you did, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter. And I will see you guys in the next video.